have been voted by over 700, about 750 people in the industry on who should be going into the Hall of Fame in Africa. They have been cleansed a lot, actually, so that's what I was talking about. Yeah, so all those votes were reviewed and monitored, made sure there was no duplicate votes. All the vote email addresses had to be valid, so those 750 were reduced a bit, but they were there. And it was amazing how many people did vote and comment, and how these individuals have obviously touched some of you people in your careers in regarding how you progressed, how you've won piece of the business in regarding revenue assurance and fraud. And this first Hall of Fame is about you guys voting for these people, because it is trying to get you guys involved in recognising yourselves and promoting yourselves, and hopefully the benefits of that, which will be that you may get big pay rises, you may get bigger budgets, and these individuals have obviously done amazing things, and hopefully as years go by there'll be more people that will be joining these people, and there'll be new faces. Many of these faces you will know because they either present, they're very proactive in the halls in regarding the conferences, etc. So I'll be very short because hopefully they will want to speak or when they're here. So there were seven nominees that were nominated by yourselves, and obviously then was a voting period which closed yesterday. And at the end of that voting, I mean, all of you, if I was me, I'd give you all an award, but I can't because opened it up to be a voting award. And I'm sure all of them will be in the Hall of Fame at some point next year, the year after, because they do amazing things. And I think even from MTN's presentation this afternoon, two or maybe potentially three have worked or been undertaking things with MTN. So that kind of gives you the idea of why MTN's phenomenal presentation, which probably shocked a few people in what they were doing, is a way how these people are progressing revenue assurance and fraud in these areas. But so, to get to it, so I'll stop waffling. I'd like to announce that the Hall of Fame award goes to Ambrose. Yes, if you'd like to stand up and come this way. Aspects where you had to comment why these people needed to be voted, and all of the people, the nominees, had some amazing comments, and I will distribute those regarding the comments to everyone, the nominees, because they were amazing. You should be very proud of what you've actually done. So before I hand over to you, I'd also like to congratulate the other people. So if Tony, I think Tony's in the back, I can see, Joseph and Nixon should also get a round of applause because they are also amazing.
I've never been speechless before. I think this is quite a shock, actually. But thank you very much. I actually didn't know what to say. I heard about this a few weeks after the nominations went through. I had no idea. I didn't see the nominations email. I didn't know what was going on. Luke sent me an email saying, congratulations, you have been nominated. I said, nominated for what? Okay, I'm flattered, thank you, goodbye. 3 weeks later, Sarah calls me and goes, Ambrose, did you tell anyone about this nomination? I said, no. She said, you're supposed to ask people to actually vote for you. So I said, okay, you know what? I'll do it, because you asked. And so I'm quite shocked, actually, to be honest. But thank you very much, thank you. I'm really flattered. It's been a long, long, long journey for all of you, the wise heads and the dinosaurs like myself, who have got your gray hair from this industry. You can't see it now, just shaved everything. There's no point showing it all the time. You know, I'm trying to look younger. But it's been a long journey in revenue assurance. It's really, really been a tough one. Anthony spoke about convincing executives yesterday. I recognize everything he said. We've done that every single time, you know, going into a new environment. Initially, 15, 20 years ago, they would ask you, revenue what? And then they'll go, is it audit? No. Assurance, what are you assuring? Are you IT people? Are you accountants, who are you? And we've come a long way from that to the point where we're talking about maturity. Yesterday we saw Vodacom's platform. Today we saw MTN. I know the Airtel group is also up there in terms of maturity. So, you know, I think everyone here can really, really be proud of what has been achieved in the last two decades. I don't think a lot of industries have done this. We've really done well, and we can pat ourselves on the back for this. So, and for those people coming into the industry, those young ones and new ones, you don't know what you're getting, honestly. You're riding on a train that's gone from a real steam train to a fast express. And you know what? I went into this industry from quality management. I'm a chemist by profession. And I came from the regular industries, chemical industry, where everything was done just in time. So it was all perfect production. And I went into KPN Mobile to do quality management. 6 months later, my boss calls me and says, "We're a startup, mate, you're wasting your time. No one's gonna listen to you. Have you noticed that?" I said, "Yes, I've noticed." "Okay, you're gonna learn telecoms now." And the truth is, I took those guys, my team, I signed in billing management, I took my team to my old company, the chemical company, Germanon, to show them what process flows are like, how to run processes, because they didn't get it. They were smart people, but we're technology, but we don't really understand these things. So I took them there to see what just-in-time management looked like. 1 second late, and your whole production process is down. 2 seconds too soon, and you have too much inventory. So you need to learn to think like that on your feet. And the key essence there for me was, if you're going to run total quality management in an environment like that, at some point, you have to become irrelevant. And remember what the lady said about robots not taking over our jobs? You know what? The day we're successful in revenue assurance is the day we're no longer relevant. It's the day everybody does this automatically without thinking about it. The day everyone from the driver to the cook to a billing manager, customer care, actually relevantly take part in the whole revenue assurance process without coming back to you to ask you what you're doing. That's the day I think would have succeeded in this industry. I don't want to waste too much time. I know Eric is in a panic. It's almost time. So, ladies and gentlemen, everyone nominated, thank you so much. Everyone who voted, thank you so much.
It's only a very small certificate. Can I ask Nixon and Joseph and Tony to just come up quickly? I know we've got a tight schedule. Well,
thank you very much. Congratulations, gentlemen.
Thanks for the voters. Nothing much more than Ambrose said. I think the firstly, thank you very much for the nomination. I don't see this as a sort of hardship because I really love RA, and you know, I've been doing it for too long. I was a bit worried what Luke said. You know, it might not be. We may not be around for too much longer. I know we know something we don't. But you know, I've worked with some great people. I have a great team. So, and as I said, it's no hardship at all because I really love what I do. So thank you.
Thank you for the nominations and congratulations to Ambrose. And if I could just add one thing about Ambrose that he probably didn't mention because he didn't want to, he's too modest. I've known him for quite a number of years, and every time you meet Ambrose, he has something that he will tell you that you didn't know. So you always learn from him. And for that, I think he deserves a win for that. I think he embodies what a real revenue assurance professional should look like and should act. Thank you.
Well done, Ambrose. Yeah, you won, but there's always next year.
Thank you very much. Back over to the schedule.
Thank you. Wow, that was awesome.